And welcome to the Archives. We're back again, and today I would like to talk to you about a deck. Now, I haven't played it yet as a recording. I'm currently recording this the night before I have a tournament that I'm going to be playing this deck in. But this is a deck that I made for just for fun to see what it was like. I had the idea. I call this deck Entertaining Encounters. And we are using the Spark Agency Worldwide Reach Division Identity for NBN, 45 minimum card deck, 15 influence. The first time each turn you res an advertisement, the runner loses a credit. We're ready to start the fire. Is the flavor text on this particular one. The Spark Agency. Tasty. Now, of course, when you're running something that requires you to run advertisements, you need to have advertisements. But I'll get into that in a minute. First, let's look at our agenda suite for this particular deck. I am running 13 agendas. This is kind of a sort of a fast advance deck in a way, because I'm running one Astroscript pilot program. You can only have one in a deck. It is a 3-2 agenda initiative. Place an agenda counter on Astroscript pilot program when you score it. The hosted agenda counter lets you place an advancement token on a card that can be advanced. I'm running three Explodapaloozas, the Sensi agendas, 4/2s. If it's accessed from R&D, the runner must reveal it. When the runner accesses it, you may gain 5 credits, which is pretty cool. So if they happen to steal this one, you get money. I don't have a problem with that. I'm running three Improved Tracers, 3/1 security agenda. All Tracer Ice have +1 strength. The base trace strength for each subroutine is increased by 1. Very handy to have, especially in an NBN deck with lots of tracers. I'm running 3 copies of License Acquisition, the 3/1 agenda expansion. When you score License Acquisition, install and res an asset or upgrade from Archives or HQ, ignoring all costs. And then I'm running 3 Rebranding Team. Initiative agendas, 4/2. All assets gain advertisement. This is why I don't have a lot of actual advertisements. I'm hoping to score a Rebranding Team near immediately. Then all of my assets gain advertisement. Then I'm always making the runner lose a credit. As you do. So that's my agenda suite, 13 agendas. I'm running 15 assets, 3 copies each. This is my basically my money, because this deck is very simple. I've got agendas, I've got ways to make money, mostly, and I've got ice, and that's it. Now, I'm running a long-term investment, 3 copies. 2 credits to res, 4 to trash. When your turn begins, place 2 credits on long-term investment. If there are at least 8 credits on long-term investment, it gains click, take any number of credits from long-term investment. I've never played with this one. I wanted to give it a try, so I figured I'd throw it in. I'm running 3 copies of Marked Accounts, 0 credits to res, 5 to trash. When your turn begins, take 1 from marked accounts if able. Click to place 3 from the bank on marked accounts. 3 copies of Pad Campaign, asset advertisement, the only advertisement that's normally an advertisement. 2 credits to res, 4 to trash. Gain 1 when your turn begins. 3 copies of Reality 3D, an asset illicit, 0 credits to res, 6 to trash. When you res Reality 3D, take 1 bad pub. When When your turn begins, gain one credit or two if the runner is tagged. So this is going to give me money every turn. Possibly one, at least one, maybe two. And as you may have noticed, all of my money cards cost at least four or higher to trash. I am also running three copies of Broadcast Square. Two credits res, five to trash. Whenever you're about to take at least one bad pub, trace three. If successful, avoid taking the bad publicity. This is so that I can get my Reality 3Ds out and not have bad pub. Now, onto the ice. I have three copies of each piece of ice that I'm running. I am running three copies of Data Ward, which is when the runner encounters Data Ward, he or she must pay three or take a tag. Six to res, strength eight, four subroutines, and the run if the runner's tagged. Three copies of Quicksand, a three to res, zero strength barrier. When the runner encounters Quicksand, place one power counter on Quicksand. Quicksand has plus one strength for each power counter on it, one subroutine, and the run. You'll probably notice a trend here really quickly. Every single piece of ice I have has a when encounter trigger. Hence why I called this entertaining encounters. Code gate, authenticator. When the runner encounters authenticator, he or she may take one tag to bypass it. A two credit res, strength four code gate. The corp gains two credits and the run. Three copies of Toll Booth. Ice code gate, eight credit res, five strength. When the runner encounters Toll Booth, he or she must pay three if able. If the runner cannot pay three, end the run with a subroutine of end the run. Data Raven in my sentry, four credit res, four strength. When the runner encounters Data Raven, he or she must either take a tag or end the run. Hosted power counter, give the runner a tag. Trace three. If successful, place one power counter on Data Raven. Sentry Tracer Turnpike. Two credit res, three strength. When the runner encounters Turnpike, he or she loses a credit. Trace five. If successful, give the runner a tag. And so basically, everything that I've got here is set up to everything is when encounter. So if the runner's running, the runner's hitting my ice, unless they're completely bypassing it, they're going to either, with Data Ward, they're going to pay three or take a tag. Quicksand just gets stronger every time they encounter it. Authenticator, they can take a tag and get past it or pay more money to break the stuff. Toll Booth, they have to pay three or end the run. Data Raven, they have to take a tag or end the run. Turnpike, they're automatically losing a credit. So they're either losing credits or taking tags, or it's just making my ice stronger. And then lastly, but not leastly, I have one more piece of ice, three copies of Loki. Yes. Six credit res Bioroid. Strength three. I've spent my entire influence on Loki for three copies of it. When the runner encounters Loki, choose another res piece of ice. Until the end of the run, Loki gains the subtypes of that ice and the subroutines of that ice before all Loki's other subroutines. End the run unless the runner shuffles his or her grip into the stack. So this not only this could basically give you trace five. If successful, give the runner a tag. Trace three. If successful, place one power counter on Data Raven. I could have end the run. I could have the corp gains two and end the run. I could have end the run. Or I could have four subroutines of end the run if the runner is tagged on Loki, plus end the run unless the runner shuffles his or her grip into her stack. This is entirely set up to have encounter ice, as I like to call it. Ice that has those when encounter triggers. because I have this, I have the Reality 3D, the broadcast square, the advertisements. All this is set up to give this a basically like it's a reality 3D show called Entertaining Encounters. Real encounters of real runners running headfirst into ice and their horrible, horrible reactions to it. I just had this weird idea to slap all these together and just to do an entire deck with nothing but ice that has when encounter triggers. So not only is something happening because they're even encountering the ice, but then they have to deal with the subroutines on top of that. I mean, just for example, imagine you have, we'll say a toll booth. We'll say a toll booth and a turnpike in front of a quicksand. So you get a toll booth and a turnpike in front of a quicksand. Say, turnpike, toll booth, quicksand. So they hit toll booth, they're losing the credit. Trace five, give the runner a tag. So they either break that or let that fire, maybe get a tag. Either way, they're spending money to break it. Then they hit a toll booth. They have to pay three or end the run. Then they have an end the run subroutine after that they have to break to get by it. Then they've hit a quicksand, which will end the run and gets a power counter. So it goes up in strength every time they hit it. The more times they hit it, the stronger it is. I just like the concept of this. So I'm going to give this a try in the tournament tomorrow. Don't know how it's going to be. I maybe won't get a chance to edit this episode until after the tournament. So maybe I will record a little bit and let you know if I have one. But I don't know. We shall see how it is. But thank you very much for watching. As always, if you like what I'm doing, please give that like button a tap. Give that subscribe button a tap as well if you haven't already, so you can be kept apprised of when I do new videos. And throw a comment in the comment section. Let me know what you think of this particular deck of mine, Entertaining Encounters. I don't know how it's going to play out. Don't know if it's going to do any good, but we shall see. I'm looking forward to giving it a shot. So do all that, and until next time, my friends, remember, keep running.